today on Hot Copy, we're joined in the studio by Ako Bicol Representative Alfredo Garbin Jr. He recently filed a resolution asking President Duterte to tap the revenue of PAGCOR to help fund two government agencies in light of PCSO's closure on some gaming activities. As you know, last night, the president has lifted the suspension effective immediately on lotto operations. Welcome to Hot Copy, Congressman.
Thank you, Karen, and thanks for having me here.
All right, let's start with this. Today is a new day for gaming. Lotto operations have already been lifted. The suspension's been lifted, but all other gaming operations remain suspended. So we have STL suspended pa yon, Kino suspended, and Periangan ng Bayan is suspended. How will this affect the government's programs?
Well, definitely it will affect the revenue collections of the government's program, especially for those mandatory contributions mandated by the PCSO. I think there are 11 to 13 laws that mandates PCSO to support and augment funding of different agencies of the government.
But
among these are Philippine Sports Commission and Commission on Higher Education. And so we really have to determine and exact the level of the shortfall of revenues. And we need the opinion of the Department of Finance. But we are thankful to the president that he already lifted the suspension on Lotto, because Lotto is the I think this is the front runner in contributing to the income of the PCSO. Second is the STL and Kino. So malaki pa rin, substantial pa rin yung mawawala.
Okay, would you have the numbers in terms of CHED, which would be very important? How much has PCSO been giving CHED every year?
Well, the mandatory contributions provided for under the law is 1% of the gross sales that goes to CHED. So hindi ko lang alam kung magkano, it depends on the collections of the PCSO, pero malaki po yon.
Pero with Lotto, now that the ban's been lifted, would it still have a dramatic effect? I mean, right now, STL operators, they claim there are 12 STL operators. The government claims they failed to remit 5 billion to PCSO for a period of a few years, which means even with the so-called failed remittance, PCSO is still able to fund CHED maybe, and the Philippine Sports Commission maybe coming from Lotto mostly.
Well, Lotto comprised 50% of the total income of PCSO. In 2018, the COA report stated that out of the 63 billion income, 31 billion comes from Lotto. And 26 from STL, 4 billion from Kino, and instant sweepstakes, I think, is 1 billion. So all in all, that's 63 billion pesos. So malaki pa rin. When it comes to STL remittance, doon talaga nagkaka-problema. You said that there were 5 billion pesos?
I think in failed remittance. Yeah,
failed
that's
remittance.
The report. Coming
kasi
from
naman,
12 STL operators.
Eh kasi naman, yung STL, ginagawang front ng weteng. Yun ang nagiging problema dito. And base sa ating mga reports, yung STL operators, yun din yung nagbubukis. Yun din yung nagpapatakbo ng weteng. And that's why, yung remittance sa PCSO and the shares of the local government units hosting, they said, betting games, nasa short change.
So pag kayong tatanungin, Congressman, mas mabuti bang illegalize na lang ang weteng? kumbaga, iba-iba na lang ang singilin na taxes. Pero in the end, just keep it all out in the open because it still exists.
Well, STL is legalized form of wetting. Ang nagkakaproblema lang, sino-shortchange yung ating gobyerno sa pag-remit ng share ng sa PCSO at sa local government units.
Kasi may street wetting eh.
At napupunta doon sa politiko, sa police. Yun naman ang ano dyan eh. Kung hindi inaalaw ng kapulisan at ng chief executives of the local government units, walang mangyayaring wetting.
So in other words, there's no need to legalize wetting because STL is legalized wetting. They need to enforce.
They need to enforce the law. They need to strictly enforce and implement the conditions of the licenses pertaining to the operations of STL. Mm-hmm. And that is what the president exactly want to address. Mm-hmm.
There's also, what can you say first with the president lifting the suspension on Lotto operations? It happened just last night.
Well, nagpapasalamat tayo dahil nakita niya na yung problema hindi naman masyado sa Lotto. Doon ito sa STL. STL can even surpass the collection and income contribution to PCSO if the loss, the licenses, and the conditions component to the said license and franchise mm-hmm. will be strictly complied with. Marami pang makokolekta.
Now, Congressman, there's a suggestion that perhaps it would be best to privatize all gaming activities and let the PCSO just serve as a collection agency of some kind. Kumbaga, ang trabaho na lang niya, mangolekta, pero pribadong sektor na ang nagpapatakbo ng gaming. Would that be efficient for you?
It is efficient if you will look at in some jurisdictions, in some countries, mm-hmm. talagang privatized.
Like the U.S.
Like the U.S. and in some other countries, in ASEAN countries. Dito sa ating bansa, if you will look at the trajectory of the collections, say in 2017, umangat in 2016, umangat 2018, umangat ng almost 65% ang collection. Mm-hmm. From 17 billion to 26 billion pesos STL collection.
Yeah.
Pag in-enforce lang yung collection,
yeah.
if there is an efficient and effective collection in the PCSO share and local government share, mm-hmm. hindi mo kailangan i-privatize.
Oo. So what do you think should be given to the PCSO to be able to enforce collection in a more powerful manner, especially with STL operators? Diba? Because, you know, Lotto, they're running it, that's easy. But STL operators, you're also confronted with businessmen who are exposed to gambling. It's a whole other world with STL.
This is a convergence effort of the law enforcement, the local government officials, and at the same time, the officials of the PCSO. As sinasabi na ating presidente dito, merong kunaibans eh. Lahat nagkunay para maipacket nila yung dapat na remitan sa PCSO na pupunta sa bulsa ng nandyan yung law enforcement, nandyan yung top officials of the PCSO, and at the same time, local government, the chief executives of the local government.
Okay. Now, you want PAGCOR to actually help CHED and the Philippine Sports Commission. You filed House Resolution Number 147. Do you still want to continue this even after Lotto is open?
Yes, Karen. As I've said, Lotto is only 50% of the total income of PCSO.
Only mandated to give 1% to CHED.
Yes.
Maliit yun.
Maliit yun. And the other half is those collections coming from STL, Kino, and other betting games that are still suspended. And so, definitely, there will be a shortfall in the revenue collections. And we have to exact the level of the financial support to PSC and CHED, considering that PSC, ayaw natin ma-hamper yung training ng ating mga atleta.
To think it's not funded enough.
Yes.
Oo.
Pangalawa, mag-host tayo ng Southeast Asian Games. So, ayaw natin magkaroon ng aberya. And sa CHED naman, we want to consider the, you know, the collegiate year had already started since June. Mm-mm. So, paano yung operasyon at yung pag-aaral ng ating mga kabataan, especially the research. So, yun yung ating ina-address dito. Oo.
So, how much, based on your House resolution, do you believe should PAGCOR give? I mean, in the last State of the Nation address of President Duterte, he congratulated PAGCOR for being now it's one of the top three cash cows of government. And I think 3 weeks ago, the president, it had turned over 16.7 billion pesos to the government coffers after BIR and Customs. So how much do you believe should PAGCOR give CHED and the Philippine Sports Commission?
I don't have the exact figure, Karen. I want to call on the Department of Finance together with the Philippine Sports Commission and CHED for them to talk about it and exact the level of the financial support that is needed to augment the funding of the two agencies. Mm-mm. Dapat mag-usap-usap. Uh-oh.
I mean, clearly the bigger picture is a lot of government projects are funded by gambling revenues. Is there any way that the government can just at least earn more, given that gambling is allowed, legal, supported in the country?
Well, that's the reality.
Kasi you also have big hotels that have, you know, high-profile and high-stake gamblers. Are we collecting enough from them?
I hope so, Karen. Sana napipinpoint din yun. But, you know, really the financial assistance, the subsidy, and of course the charitable works, most of which are coming from gambling money.
Mm-mm.
And as I have said earlier, there are 13 laws that says that PCSO and PAGCOR are really mandated to augment and contribute to the funding of different agencies. Among others is the Philippine Sports Commission, the CHED. Of course, recently is the Universal Healthcare Program, where we needed at least 257 billion pesos to operationalize the said law.
Now, as it is, apparently, lotto sales are down by 30%. Kumbaga, paunti ng paunti na ang tumataya sa lotto. If it's down by 30%, what is the long-term solution you're seeing if CHED and PCSO need money from lotto?
Well, we need to.
So you want PAGCOR?
PAGCOR. Oo. And, you know, PAGCOR, pero aside from their mandatory contributions, in totality, yung natira nilang pondo, it is remitted to the president's as social fund.
I see.
Pwede rin kunin doon. Billion-billion rin.
I'm curious, would you have the division, let's say, of the 16.7 billion of PAGCOR, how much of the pie goes to the president's fund?
Ganito yon. Yung 5% goes to the franchise tax, and the 50% of the 95% remaining goes to the subsidies.
Mm-mm.
And
pero walang CHED and PSC doon.
Nandun na yung mga mandatory contributions.
Sa PAGCOR to, ha?
Sa PAGCOR. And the remaining income is remitted to the Office of the President for President's Social Fund.
So technically, what you want, the story today should be you want less money to be remitted to the President's Social Fund and more of the pie to go to CHED and PSC directly or these agencies?
No, the premise of my resolution is not to confer power to the president, but to urge the president to exercise his power of control and supervision over all executive offices such as PAGCOR and PCSO. Kung may kakulangan dito sa PCSO, sa kanyang mandatory contributions,
but
kumuha doon sa PAGCOR.
That would be very discretionary. It would depend on who the president is. In other words, if you end up with a president na ayaw niya, I like my social fund on my own, nothing would happen. It would affect programs. So ang tanong ko, for PAGCOR to increase donations to these agencies, do you need congressional approval for this? Or is the president's discretion enough?
It is, emanates from the president's power of control and supervision over all executive departments, under which kasama na dyan, it speaks of executive departments, bureaus and offices, kasama dyan yung PAGCOR and PCSO.
So you don't need the House itself, your resolution, the resolution you filed, if the president agrees, that's enough?
Yes.
Or you would also need Senate concurrence?
No.
No more?
No. What we're showing is this is the sense of the House of Representatives for the president to exercise that power.
Do you believe you'd have the support of the majority on this?
Yeah, when you speak of education, sports budget, that's no brain. Sasama yan. Na talaga naman na susuportahan nila.
Okay.